Well, we've got a very exciting morning happening. It's Father's Day. Yeah. And it's Compassion Sunday. Woo! You guys just don't know what Compassion Sunday means yet, but by the end of the service, we'll say, it's Compassion Sunday, and you'll go, there you go. We're getting there. Well, I'm Tom. I'm one of the pastors here at the church, and I'm thrilled that you're all here this morning on this lovely Father's Day. I have a few announcements. The first announcement is that next week is the beginning of summer. There we go. Summer programs begin June 26th. So that means that we need sign up for summer leaders for Kids Church. And you can sign up at the Kids Church table. There's that big sign up board. So sign up there and sign up for Kids Church for this summer as well. Next week is the beginning of our acoustic Sunday worship throughout the summer. We've got some awesome things planned for that. We've got special guests coming in, just like this morning, to lead worship. So summer is upon us, right? Yeah. As well, something that's exciting that's starting this summer is that we're going to continue our relationship over at Calgary Housing. And we're putting in a sports shed full of sports memorabilia. And we're going to build that shed. So that's the first step, is building the shed next Sunday. So if you are good at building stuff, you're good with tools and drills, we have a huge 7x7 shed that needs to be put together. So dads, if you get like a new drill for Father's Day, let's put it to good use. As well, if you have sports equipment that we want to fill up, we're going to fill up this shed so that we can just pop in every Sunday. Is that what we're thinking? Just go over there, play soccer with the kids, and just spend some time building into our community. So that's next Sunday. Talk to Lori. Lori, will you stand up? Or raise your hand, either one. Talk to Lori, and she'll get you all the information. That's next Sunday. As well, like I said, it's Father's Day today. And to honor our fathers, we're going to eat ice cream sandwiches in the foyer. You like that idea. Ice cream sandwiches are the perfect way. Speaking as a father, that's the perfect way to honor me. Just remember that, my son's there in the front row. I want to introduce our guest this morning. John Bauer is here to lead worship, to share his heart for kids, for compassion. And I'm sure he's going to share a lot more about that. But John is a worship leader, songwriter from St. Albert. Is that correct? Not just Edmonton, St. Albert. So we welcome you with open arms, even though you're from the opposing team up there. Some sports team. I can't do the reference prep. As well, we have Compassion out in the foyer, and where you guys are going to hear all about that this morning. John has a table that you can get his amazing CDs, and he's got some great deals this morning, because we're going to hear some of his music, and he's going to just bless us this morning. Why don't we stand and greet one another as John comes up, and yeah.
Well, good morning. How are you doing this morning? Let's try that again. Come on. Good morning. How are you doing this morning? It is so good to see you, and thank you for your grace. I am sorry I'm from Edmonton. I wish we could all be from Calgary, but it is an honor to be with you this morning and to join with you in worship, because Jesus is worthy of our praise in all times, in all situations. Amen. And so it's a privilege to join with you and your church family in worship this morning. And you know what? I grew up as a little boy in church. I grew up at Spruce Grove Alliance Church, just outside of Edmonton. And back in those days when I was growing up, we had so many different generations in our church family. And as I look out this morning, I see that this morning, so many generations worshiping God together. And that is such an encouragement. The church needs so many generations. And when I was a young boy, back in the day in our church growing up, I'm not sure when you grew up in church, but back in the day when I grew up, drums were a little bit illegal in church. Does anyone remember those days? Some of you do. I see that hand. And you know what? My goal, we had to use our hands to keep the beat. And so my goal back when I was a young boy was to clap my heart out for Jesus. And I practiced my clap so much every Sunday that the older generation would always look back and stare at little John Bauer because I clapped so loud in our church. And it was a gift that I worked on very hard. And so we're going to sing a song that I used to sing when I was a little boy in church. And this involves a little bit of hand clapping. So if it's okay, I need you to help me. Now, when I was driving to church this morning when I woke up, I went on your church website because I love to learn a little bit more about churches. And one of the amazing things I learned is that Pastor Tom is a very gifted banjo player. Have you heard him play the banjo before? All right. And so, Tom, I asked him just last minute, would you join with me for this first song? So, Tom, you got your banjo? Would you like to see Tom with his banjo this morning? Come on. Who would not like to see Tom with his banjo? Raise your hands out there. Okay, I don't see any hands, so we're going to continue. But this song needs a little bit of your help this morning. This song is called Blessed Be the Name. It goes like this.
Blessed be the name, blessed be the name.
Yeah.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Yeah.
Blessed be the name, blessed be the name. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Keep that going. But here we go, Tom.
All praise to Him who reigns above. In majesty supreme, who gave His Son for man to die, that He might man redeem.
Blessed be, here you go.
Blessed be the name, blessed be the name, blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name, yeah. Blessed be the name. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Would you be free from the burden of sin? As power in the blood, yeah, power in the blood. Would you, O evil, a victory win? This wonderful power in the blood. There is power, power, oh, wonder-working power in the blood. In the precious blood of the Lamb. Oh, and would you do service for Jesus your King? As power in blood, power in blood. Would you live daily His praises to sing? His wonderful power in the blood. There is power, power, oh, wonder-working power in the blood of the Lamb. There is power, power, wonder-working power in the precious blood of
just the voices. Here we go.
There is power, power, wonder-working power in the blood of the Lamb. There is power, power, wonder-working power in the precious blood of the Lamb.
Amen. Thanks, Tom.
Oh, our God is greater. Our God is stronger. God, you are higher than any other. Our God is healer, awesome in power. Open the eyes of the blind, the snow. ashes we rest. There's no one like you, none like you. 'Cause our God, 'cause our God is greater, our God is stronger. God, you are higher than any other. Our God is healer, awesome in power. Darkness, sing that out. Oh, into the darkness we shine. Out of the ashes we rise. There's no one like you, none like you. 'Cause our God is greater, our God is stronger. God, you are higher than any other. Our God is here. You are higher than any other. Our God is healer, awesome in power. Our God, yeah.
Let's declare this morning that if our God is for us, then there is no one and there is nothing in this world that can stand against us. You believe that this morning? Let's lift these words up. If our God.
And if our God is for us, then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, then what could stand against? And if our God is for us, then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, then what could stand against? Yeah. What could stand? Our God is stronger. God, you are higher than any other. Our God is healer, awesome in power. Our God, our God is greater. Our God is stronger. God, you are higher than any other. Our God is healer, awesome in power. If our God is for us, then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, then what could stand against? And if our God is for us, then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, then what could stand against? And what could stand
this morning? I just want to encourage you as we continue in worship. You know, a couple weeks ago, I had the privilege of being on tour in Germany. And while I was over there, God reminded me of something that had happened the year before when we were singing, when we were worshiping Jesus together. There was a lady who had come into the service that night, and she had lost her hearing for about 15 years. And she had been praying daily, Lord, would you restore my healing, my hearing? Would you heal me? Day after day, she prayed. It was in one of her ears, the other one she could hear. And for some reason, years and years and years, God for some reason did not heal her. But in faith that day, in the service, as we were singing this song that she'd sung many times before, our God is greater, our God is stronger, he is higher than any other, he is my healer. And as she sang that word, in that moment, God miraculously brought back her hearing, as she faithfully just prayed that to God that day. You know, sometimes we sing songs, we sing them so many times, And we sometimes forget the power of the words that we're singing, the truths that we're singing out about our Savior. This morning, what if God wants to bring healing to one of us in a miraculous way? Maybe it's in your health, or maybe your finances, maybe a relationship that's broken. I have no idea what ways all of us need healing this morning. But God is alive. He is active. He is here in our midst. He promises that when two or more are gathered in His name, that He is here. Would you just close your eyes with me this morning? Let's just pray those words of that chorus one more time in faith. Our God is greater. Our God is stronger. God, You are higher than any other. Our God is healer and awesome in power. Our God, and if our God, and if our God is for us, then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, then what could stand against? And if our God is for us, then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, then what could stand against? Then what could stand against? Our God is greater. Our God is stronger. God, You are higher than any other. Our God is healer, awesome in power. Our God, sing that one more time. Our God is greater. Our God is stronger. God, You are higher than any other. Our God is healer, and awesome in power. Our God, our God. Yes.
Well, I heard a thousand stories of what they think you're like, but I heard a tender whisper of love in the dead of night, and You tell me that Your peace and that I'm never alone. Your good, good Father is who You are, is who You are. Who You are, and I'm loved by You. It's who I am. It's who I am. It's who I am. Well, I've seen many searching for answers far and wide, but I know we're all searching for answers. Only You provide, 'cause You know just what we need before we say a word. Your good, good Father is who You are, is who You are, is who You are. And I'm loved by You, is who I am, is who I am. I am. You are. You are perfect in all of Your ways. You are perfect in all of Your ways. You are perfect in all of Your ways. To us, You are perfect. You are perfect in all of Your ways. You are perfect in all of Your ways.
You are perfect in all of your ways to us. Love so undeniable, I can hardly speak. The peace so unexplainable, I can hardly think as you fall. Deeper still as you fall. Deeper still as you fall. Deeper still into love. Love, love, love. You're a good, good Father. It's who you are. It's who you are. It's who you are. And I'm loved by you. It's who I am. It's who I am. It's who I am. You're a good, good Father. It's who you are. It's who you are. It's who you are. And I'm loved by you. It's who I am. It's who I am. It's who I am. Let's just close our eyes and sing that one more time. You're good, good Father. It's who you are. It's who you are. It's who you are. And I'm loved by you. It's who I am. Who I am. It's who I am. On this Father's Day, we thank you for your amazing grace, your amazing love. Your love that sent your one and only Son to the cross for us. You say, God, whoever believes in your Son Jesus will not die, but have everlasting life. So, Father, we thank you that on this Father's Day, we can pause in this moment and thank you for the greatest gift that we could have ever received, and that is life in you. Jesus, you are worthy of our praise this morning, not based on how we feel or the situations or circumstances in life, but because you are a faithful God. You will never leave us. You will never forsake us. And we worship you and you alone this morning. We pray this in Jesus' name, that all God's people said, amen. Amen. Would you please be seated this morning as we continue? Well, this morning as we continue in worship, I just pray that some of the words that I speak would maybe speak to your hearts this morning in the journey that you're on with Him. And the song I want to share with you now, it's a song that speaks of God's faithfulness. It's from the new CD that I've been working on these last few years. And I'm going to be honest with you, this last CD has been one of the most difficult ones in my life to write. You see, because a few years ago, when I was on tour down in the States, I was driving with my family. Normally my wife and my kids are with me and ministering around the world together. Unfortunately, my wife had some circumstances with her family in Toronto this weekend that she was not able to be here. Normally, they're here with us and ministering as a family together. But when we were ministering a few years ago now down in Florida, I know it was very rough serving Jesus in Florida. But as we were in our motorhome, we were driving on the interstate back up to Canada. And in the middle of driving on the interstate, all of a sudden, I just started to black out. And I almost lost control of our motorhome, and my wife and kids were on the bed in the back just having some time together. And I had to do everything in my power just to steer that motorhome off the road and get it stopped so we didn't have a tragic accident. And in that moment, all of a sudden, I just started having stroke-like symptoms that came out of nowhere. I mean, everything in life was perfect. Everything was going the way it should have been going, and then all of a sudden, in an instant, it wasn't. And all of a sudden, I couldn't even drive our motorhome back up to Edmonton. My wife, who'd never driven this thing, had to drive all the way back to Edmonton for our family. And in the months to come, I just started having anxiety like I had never had in my life. I've never been anxious about anything. But all of a sudden, I was anxious about everything. I was laying in bed in the middle of the night with tears coming down my face saying, Lord, would you heal me? I don't know where this has come from. And I just would have panic attacks out of nowhere. And I just had to take about a 5 or 6 month sabbatical from ministry. And I just prayed every single day, Lord, would you bring healing to me? And I didn't hear God's voice back. I cried out to him night after night, Lord, where are you when I need you the most? And in that moment, all I could hear Jesus whisper was John say, John, trust in my faithfulness. I will never leave you. I have never forsaken you. Remember how I have been faithful. And I will continue to be faithful. Great is your faithfulness, oh my God. Your mercy is all that I see. Great is your faithfulness, oh my God. And all that you've given to me. And so that is what our family sang. Great is your faithfulness, oh God. Your mercy, that's all I can see. And daily our family prayed that. Daily we prayed for healing, and it did not happen immediately. But in God's time, in his place, he chose to allow me to have complete healing, and I'm so thankful for that. But that was a struggle of my life. Just saying, Lord, where are you in the midst of this? I don't sense your presence. But God just whispering, John, trust in my faithfulness, for I am good. And this was the song that our family sang. And this morning, some of you, as I look into your eyes this morning, maybe some of you are facing some of those moments in life where you don't know how you're going to face tomorrow because of maybe health or finances or relationships that are broken. If you have the strength this morning to sing these words with me, would you do that? And if you don't, allow me to sing these words for you on your behalf to the Father. But I just encourage you this morning, you know, I believe that God wants to use not only the greatest times in our life to bring glory to his name. He wants to use the most difficult times to bring glory to his name. And he wants to use your life as a testimony to his greatness. So would you join with me? Would you just try this chorus with me this morning? It goes like this. Great is your faithfulness, oh my God. Your mercy is all that I see. Great is your faithfulness, oh my God. And all that you've given to me. Would you try that with us? Great is, let's sing. Great is your faithfulness, oh my God. Your mercy is all that I see. Great is your faithfulness, oh my God, and all that you've given to me. The verse goes like this. In the story of my life, you are present on every page. Every line holds no doubt. You are constant and you never change. Your love is patient, your love is kind. And you love brought me, yet brought me to the light. Would you sing, great is, Great is your faithfulness, oh my God. Your mercy is all that I see. Great is your faithfulness, oh my God. All that you've given to me, morning by morning. Morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, you've given to me. Morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, you've given to me. Sing that out. Morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, you've given to me. Great is, oh, great is your faithfulness, oh my God. Your mercy is all that I see. Great is your faithfulness, oh my God, and all that you've given to me. Just a voice is in you, you'll sing it out. Oh, great is your faithfulness, oh my God. Your mercy is all that I see. Great is your faithfulness, oh my God, in all that you've given to me. And all that you've given to me. Yes, all that you've given to me. Thank you, Father. Amen. Amen. Well, as I look out, I'm so blessed to see, as I mentioned earlier, so many different generations this morning worshiping Jesus. And some of you maybe knew this, some of you maybe had no idea, but back about 12 years ago, before I started doing full-time music ministry, I used to be an elementary school teacher. And so I used to sing with my class every day, and I used to teach in a Christian program in the public school system in St. Albert. And I used to be essentially worship pastor in the class every day with my kids and got to sing out the praises of Jesus. And so I'm not sure if you... Are you in school, some of you? I think you are, as I look out and I see you. And so if you are in diapers, okay, and you can waddle your way up here, all right, all the way up to grade 6, I need your help for a song this morning. So if you are in diapers all the way up to grade 6, would you come forward and help me? Come right on up here, and I need your help for a song this morning. Yeah, let's encourage them. Come on up, guys. Come on, right on. Come on up, boys. Come on, come on. Come on, girls. Fantastic. I love it. I love it. Come right up on the stage, and you can stand right in the front, okay? Stand right in the front. Awesome. Awesome, boy. It's good to see you this morning. Did you remember that today was Father's Day? Some of you did? Awesome. Fantastic. If you are a little bit shorter, come to the front so we can see your beautiful face this morning. I love it. Excellent. You can come right on up. Come right on up in the front. Excellent. Excellent. Good, good. And I'm going to get you boys just to scoot over just a little bit, because I'm going to need to go in there in a second. But when I was a little boy, just about your age, sir, how old are you? You're 6 years old. High five. I'm glad you know your age. That's fantastic. When I was 6 years old, I used to go to church as a little boy with my mom and dad. And one of the songs that we would sing in church when I was a little boy was a song called Peace Like a River. Has anyone ever heard that song before? A few of you. Fantastic. Do you still sing that here this at all? It's awesome. I love it. And so it's very simple, but there's some actions that go with the song, okay? So let's try this. Put your peace fingers up. Well, I've got peace like a river. I've got peace like river. I've got peace like river in my soul. Point your shoe. Very good. I've got peace like river. I've got peace like river. I've got peace like river in my soul. Point your shoe. Excellent. Now, when I was in the classroom with my boys and girls, they said, Mr. Bauer, they said, we live in Alberta, all right? And in Alberta, almost every boy and girl is a cowboy. Is that true? Especially in Calgary, right? Yes. So on the count of three, I want to hear the biggest yeehaw that Dalhousie Church has ever heard. Is this allowed, Pastor Shane? All right. I just need to clear it with the pastor. Now, he says it's okay, so I need you to give it. All right? On the count of three, I need you to get your arm into it, okay? Like this. Yeehaw! All right? Now, some of you may need to adjust out there, okay? All right? Here we go. One, two, three. Yeehaw! One more time. One, two, three. Yeehaw! All right. I love it. So that's what we sing after each line. Now, the next one goes, I've got joy. Let me see the smiles on your face. Joy like a fountain, I've got joy like a fountain, I've got joy like a fountain in my soul. Yeah, you know it. Yeehaw! I've got joy like a fountain, I've got joy like a fountain, I've got joy like a fountain in my soul. Yeehaw! And last one is, I've got love like an ocean. So give yourself a big hug. I've got love, and then you plug your nose and go under the water. Now, I hurt my back this week landscaping, so I won't go too low, but you can go all the way down to the ground, okay? I've got love like an ocean. I've got love like an ocean. I've got love like an ocean in my soul. All right? I've got love like an ocean. I've got love like an ocean. I've got love like an ocean in my soul. All right, now you have all three lines. Now, we're going to put all three lines together. Okay, and they're going to go like this. I've got peace like a river. I've got joy like a fountain. I've got love like an ocean in my soul. I've got peace like a river. I've got joy like a fountain. I've got love like an ocean in my soul. Perfect. All right. Are the boys and girls doing a good job this morning? I love it. Okay. Now, I am going to go and play guitar, all right? And I'm going to lead us in the guitar. But do you think you're going to remember all these actions? Some of you are shaking your head. No, I know. I know. I agree with you. It is going to be very tough. And I woke up this morning and I said, Jesus, what should we do? Because, you know, when I start playing guitar, sometimes we forget the actions and then it's confusion. And we don't want confusion in church. So I said, you know, Lord, who is going to be the lead cowboy and lead cowgirl, right, to lead us in these actions? And Pastor Shane, I heard, is such an incredible action worship leader. Would you come and join with me, my friend? I'm never going to be invited back to your church, am I? But I don't want you to be by yourself. So, Pastor Tom, would you come on up as well? All right. I love it. You guys are good sports. Fantastic. Let me grab my guitar here, sir. Perfect. No, you guys are front and center. Yeah, this is, yeah. No, right up here, Tom, and you, yes, and the youth pastor also. Yeah, fantastic. I love it. Yeah. Good. All right, and we have one last. Heather, where's Heather? Come on up. All right, I love it. You guys are good sports. Fantastic. Now, here's the thing. I'm going to allow the pastors to be down on the bottom so then the kids can still see you well and you can still see the kids. All right, so no, not sitting down, right standing facing all the congregation, right? And because we want the children to lead us in worship this morning. So would you stand with us, all right? And we're all going to do the actions together, all right? I'm not going to leave these guys high and dry doing them themselves. But I need you guys to turn around and face them because we need video cameras coming out at this point, all right? We're going to have some fun. So we're going to start it slow, okay? And we're going to work it up to a runaway train, aren't we, guys? Yes, a runaway train, all right? Yes. This is live. I did not even know that. All right, so let's not make any mistakes this morning. All right, here we go now. Well, I've got peace like a river. I've got joy like a fountain. I've got love like an ocean in my soul. Yeah, I've got peace. You got it. Love. I've got peace, I've got joy, I've got love in my soul, yeah. I've got peace, I've got joy, I've got the... Well, here we go. I've got peace. I got joy. I've got love in my soul. I've got peace. I got joy. I've got love. Yeah, here we go. I've got peace. I got joy. I've got love in my soul. I got peace like a river, I got joy like a fountain, I've got love like an ocean in my soul. Alright, let's put our hands together, here we go. I got peace like a river, I got joy like a fountain, I got love like an ocean in my soul. I got peace like a river, I got joy like a fountain, I got love like an ocean in my soul. Yeah! Let's give our pastors and kids one big yee-haw. One, two, three. Yee-haw! I am never going to be invited back, but thank you for your grace this morning. Kids, you are dismissed to go down to Children's Church at this time, and I'll pass it back to Pastor Shea.
All right. Did y'all all have fun? Yes. If I see this on social media, I am going to pray James chapter 1 for every one of you. All right. I'm going to ask at this time if our ushers would take their places, and we're going to take the offering, and we're going to practice being generous. Amen? I'm just letting these guys talk over here before we pray. I'm just playing. James chapter 1 is patience during trials and testings and hardships, and yes, all right. They're testing it to see how bad it would be before they post it. That's great. All right. Did I mention I really don't like you that much? All right. Let's pray. Father, I come before you this morning, and I thank you for everything that's taken place, even the awkwardness of what just happened. Father, you are a good God, and you delight in your children. You're generous. You're kind, and you're compassionate. Father, this morning I pray that as you have invited us to worship, not only through music and awkward movement, but you've invited us to participate in being generous as well. Father, I pray that we would give generously. In your name I pray. Amen. Real quick, church, yesterday, well done. Well done. You guys that served and gave of your time and you poured out your love on Marty and Jake and the Thiessen family, I just want to say to you, well done. Yesterday was a good day. Amen. So thank you, Diane. Thank you for you and your team. They did an excellent job with the food yesterday. It was just amazing. So thank you. I was a very proud pastor yesterday. Very, very well done. Thank you. Thank you.
Well, this morning, Pastor Shane and Pastor Tom have been so gracious to say, John, you know, it's okay. You take the service this morning, and you do as many action worship songs with me that you want to do. And I'm kidding. We will not do any more action worship songs, but thanks for your grace this morning. But they said, you know, just share and share your heart on music and worship as well as compassion this morning. And so I have about 2 or 3 hours prepared, and we're going to get out of here about 3 or 4 today. Kidding. We'll be out of here very soon, but going to share a few songs with you this morning. And my prayer this morning is that no matter what situation or circumstance you're at in life this morning, that God would whisper to your heart. And I'm not sure if you listen to Shine FM here in Calgary, but this is one of the songs that they're playing for me right now. The song is called Say Something. Lord, say something. Oh, say something. I need to know that you are here with me. Sometimes I feel alone. I'm at the end of my rope, trying to keep my head above the water. Been too weak to admit that I should stop and submit, find the peace that only you can offer. Oh, 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 will you come and speak to me? Don't say something, oh, say something. I need to know that you are here with me. Don't say something, oh, say something. I want to hear you, so I'm listening, yeah. Say something to me, yeah. Say something to me. Cause there are moments and days when all I see is the rain, and in my mind I just can't make sense of it. Will you whisper so loud and call me out of my doubt, for me to focus my eyes on you, Jesus? Oh, 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 will you come and speak to me? Lord, say something, oh, say something. I need to know that you are here with me. Lord, say something, oh, say something. I want to hear you, so I'm listening. Yeah. Say something to me, oh. Say something to me. I'm on my knees right now. God, would you speak somehow? Oh, say something to me. When you reveal your will, my heart begins to heal. Oh, say something to me. I'm on my knees right now, God, would you speak somehow? Oh, say something to me. When you reveal your will, my heart begins to heal. Oh, say something to me. So, Lord, say something. Oh, say something. I need to know that you are here with me. Lord, say something. Oh, say something. I want to hear you, so I'm listening.
Altogether worthy, altogether one.
faithful to me. I don't have the words for this song. Oh, I guess I do. They found me. But let's just stand this morning. Just sing this chorus to Jesus one more time. Here I am to worship you, Father.
So here I am to worship. Here I am to bow down. Here I am to say that you're my God. You're altogether loving, altogether worthy, altogether wonderful to me. I'll never know.
Mentioned earlier that normally when I'm ministering on the road, my wife of 13 years now, we just celebrated that a week ago, and our son and our daughter, we minister together. And I think, do we have a picture of my wife and kids here somewhere? Let's see if they're here. My wife isn't there, but my kids are. All right, I appreciate it. Our son Emerson now is 8 years old, and our daughter Avalyn is 6 years old. And as you can see there on the snow in our backyard there, smiling for Jesus. But normally our family comes and shares this next song together. And my kids come up on the stage and I kneel down beside them. And as they sing, I whisper into their ear. And I say, Daddy loves you. I love you. And this morning, as I look into your eyes this morning, from the heart of God the Father to you, He wants to whisper that into your ear. He wants you to hear those words, I love you, I love you, I love you. You know what? There is nothing that you have done in this lifetime. No mistakes that you have made, no sins that you have committed that would make God love you less. His love for you, it is unfailing, it is unconditional. And the heart of the Father says, I love you, I love you, I love you. And in the same breath, there is nothing in this world, no amount of songs you could sing or service you could do or sheds you could build next weekend and filled with sports equipment to make him love you more. His love for you, it's something so hard to fathom. He loves you, he loves you, he loves you. And the level of God's love will never, ever diminish. And this morning, my prayer is that you would hear these words, that there is nowhere you could go on this earth where God's love is not chasing after you. Is that a good promise from God this morning? This song is called Chasing After Me.
Taking me to anywhere, but where you want me. And I try to keep things constantly moving, hoping for a faster way.
you're doing, but your love is chasing after me, chasing after me. There's nowhere I could ever hide, cause you keep coming. Your love is chasing after me, chasing after me. I don't know what I've been running from, yeah. Yeah, yeah, I've been running from. You see, always know what I'm thinking. Wonder why I feel so sad. Escaping, but I see it's all a matter of choosing. But I've learned without your love, all that I'm losing. Your love is chasing after me, chasing after me. There's nowhere I could ever hide, cause you keep coming. Your love is chasing after me, chasing after me. I don't know why I've been running, cause you never let me down. You're there when I turn around, pointless to try to run away. There's nothing I could do. I know there's nothing left to prove. This love will never ever fade. Oh, 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 yeah. 'Cause your love is chasing after me, chasing after me. There's nowhere I could ever hide, 'cause you keep coming. Your love is chasing after me, chasing after me. I don't know why I've been running. Your love is chasing after me, chasing after me. There's nowhere I could ever hide, 'cause you keep coming. Your love is chasing after me, chasing after me. I don't know what I've been running from, yeah. Yeah, I've been running from. Oh, it's chasing after me. Yeah, I've been running from. Oh, it's your love chasing after me. Thanks so much. It's been an honor to join with you this morning. And this morning, I have the privilege of sharing a little bit more about our family. And you know what? For a second, I just want you to pretend that it's wintertime, okay? I want you to pretend that it's cold outside. And, you know, it's very cold outside, right? It gets very cold here. And you know what I'm talking about. And so, you know what? Let's just warm up a little bit. I'm just going to start a little bit of a fire. Let's see if we can get... There you go. All right. Just warm up on that fire, all right? Warm your hands up and just pretend that I'm going to share a bit of a story with you. And this is from our family's heart to yours this morning. But, you know, one of the ways that our family has been not only singing out our worship, we've just been singing out our worship, but one of the ways that we have been living out our worship the last 12, 13 years now has been through child sponsorship. And the reason we've done that is because God has blessed us here in Canada, and it's so that we can be a blessing. And sponsorship of a little child, just like this little one here. His name is Little Soki, and he's from Bangladesh, and he's 8 years old now. And sponsorship of a little child like Soki, what it comes down to, it's $41 a month. It's kind of like a dollar a day, kind of like the price of a cup of coffee. And actually, I'm not sure, do you guys have Starbucks here in Calgary? You know, I've figured it out that if you go every morning for your Starbucks, your coffee at Starbucks. I've added up the numbers. Yeah, and what I added up is that you could sponsor a whole village of kids. It's unbelievable. And when you sponsor a child, you could write to them, or you could even go and visit them someday. And that's what we did. We wanted to see if Compassion was doing what they said they're going to do. And so about 4 years ago, my wife and I, we had the privilege of going down to Dominican Republic. And we got to meet one of our little children for the very first time. And I just want to introduce you to him this morning in this first photo there. There's little 8-year-old Yordi, and in his hand, you see that picture envelope. And I'm going to be honest with you. For so many years, I always said, yeah, right. Come on. The children that Compassion puts in these envelopes, it's not really the child. It's just a random child that they said, hey, stop for a second. I just want to take a picture of you. They take a picture of a random child and put it in the envelope, and they say it's our child. So what I did was I took our envelope off of our fridge, all right, and I flew it all the way down to Dominican Republic. So when little Yordi walked up, I had his picture in my hand. I looked at the picture, and I looked at him. I looked at the picture and closer at him just to make sure. And as you can see, it was exactly little Yordi, our sponsor child. And we got to spend time with him and see what a difference our prayers and support have made. But we got to go back a second year in a row, and that's what this next picture is. Yordi, now a year older, 9 years old, a year closer to Jesus. The little one in the middle, that's little six-year-old Verna. We sponsored her when we came home from our first trip from meeting Yordi because we were so impacted with what we saw Jesus doing there. And so we got to meet her for the very first time, little Verna in the middle. And then beside my wife, Andrea, that's little five-year-old Jesus. And he wasn't our sponsored child when we went down on this trip. But we went to one of the church projects that Compassion is partnered with. And they had a seat safe for me in the front. And so I sat down. And this five-year-old little boy, he looked up at me. And he smiled, the biggest smile I've ever seen. And then all of a sudden, without saying a word, he got up. And he walked to the front and pressed play on a little CD player. And all of a sudden, he closed his eyes. And as this worship music started to play, he just did actions unto God for nearly 5 minutes of silence. This five-year-old little boy worshiped God as if there was no one else in the room. And I went to the pastor and I said, would you share me his story? And he said, well, Jesus and his brother Dan, they joined the program this last year, and his brother Dan was sponsored immediately, but little Jesus, he's been praying every day that God would bring him a sponsor, and he hasn't got one yet. And in that moment, Jesus just whispered to my heart, said, John, why not you? Why not here? Why not right now? And so my wife and I just conversed, and we said, yes, Father, we believe that this is something we could do. And so we went into a room with his translator, and we said to little Jesus, and it was translated, we said, would you allow us to be your sponsor family? And as soon as this was translated to him, he didn't use words to respond back to the translator. What he did was he lunged into my arms. And this little boy I had never met in my life, he held on to me like he had known me his entire life, like I was his father. And he would not let go. Because he knew in that moment and moving forward that his life was forever going to be changed through this simple act of faithfulness that our family started to take part in. But we've been to our children's families' homes, and this next picture is Yordi's family, his mom and dad in the middle there, and some brothers that live in the community there. And I didn't realize it in this moment, because this was a good four and a half years ago. But if you look carefully at this picture, this was the very first case, all right, a photobombing in the Dominican Republic. All right, it happened right there. But what we discovered is that through our support, that our children and their families have clean water and food and shelter, all of those basics that sometimes we just take for granted. But not just that, they have health checkups and immunizations. They have their school and school supplies provided for them. But one of the most exciting things, the thing that makes us most excited about Compassion is what we found when we went down there. You see, because Compassion partners with local churches. Compassion operates church in first world to church in third world relationship. And so not only do the kids receive the basic needs, but all of our kids receive spiritual needs. Because, you know, it's wonderful and it's essential, you know, to give food and water and clothing and shelter to those in need. But food and shelter and water and clothing isn't what's going to get them to heaven. that's going to get them to heaven is a relationship with Jesus. And so that's what Compassion is all about. They're not a sponsorship organization. Truly what we realize is that they're a discipleship program, raising children out of poverty, just like you, sir, in Jesus' name. And we realize that day after day as we spent time there. This next picture is Yordi's pastor, and he sees him every single week and every single day as he goes to the Compassion program at the church there. But not just a local pastor, every single child in Compassion has a Christian tutor that works with them 3 to 4 times a week, not just on their schooling, but on the relationship with Jesus. And we just saw the mentoring process of these little ones firsthand. And we got to go to many of these church projects. And on one day, we crossed through the front door of one project. And there was, as soon as I crossed through the front door, I heard the voice of a 12-year-old little girl. And she was standing in front of all 300-400 other boys and girls, other sponsored children. And she was speaking to them about David and Goliath. And she said, "My friends, my brothers and sisters, all of us, we are going to face Goliath in life, but with Jesus' hope and help and strength," she said, "we can rise above that. We can be a David." And this 12-year-old little sponsored child, she spoke to the other boys and girls for nearly 45 minutes with more passion and conviction in her 12-year-old little heart than I ever have from a single stage. And Jesus said in the moment, "John, take notice of what's going on here. Because I'm not just providing the basics through Compassion. I am raising up a generation of children that will be my light to this world, in their families, in their communities, in their homes, and in their countries, in their schools, in their jobs." And you know, we saw this firsthand on the last day of our trip when he got to sit around the table of the restaurant with 5 men and women. You see, I think we got that picture here. 2 of them are engineers. 1 is a linguist with the United Nations. 1 is a cardiac surgeon. And the last is a child psychologist. And you see, every single one of them are Compassion sponsored children that started in the program and now graduated. And what they said to me, "John, what Compassion did for us, it gave us permission to hope, to believe that in Jesus' name, the poverty we always knew growing up, that we did not need to remain in that. But they said, with Jesus' hope and strength, we could rise above that." And they said, "Now our goal in life, it's not to simply make more money. It's to go back to the villages where we grew up and to be living proof for the other boys and girls that there is hope in Jesus' name, and we are living proof of that hope," they said. You know, this morning as I was driving here, I was praying for you. I didn't know who was going to be here, but now as I look out and I see you, and I was saying, "Jesus, what would you love to see happen?" And I just heard Jesus whisper, "John, what if we saw 20 children raised out of poverty in my name this morning? What could I do with 20 little lives that are sold out for me?" And I have no idea if Jesus will whisper to you this morning to be one of those 20 families or 2 friends or individuals. But we're going to watch a short clip. And this clip is called "Grace Finds Hope." And as we watch it this morning, would you simply just ask God, "God, are you whispering to my heart this morning?" Let's watch this together. This is Grace Finds Hope.
Listen. That voice above us is never quiet.
"I'm not worth anything. I'm ugly. Nobody loves me.
I was holding my baby sister when she died. She got a cold, and she never got better.
I'm hungry. My family shared 1 egg for dinner last night. My stomach hurts.
Is God real? Will he send someone to help me?"
"My name is Grace. No one ever tell me they love me. I'm looking for hope."
Hope. Let it go. Those pictures of kids in poverty are heartbreaking. But someone else will sponsor Grace. Right?
all about making a difference. But where am I going to get the money?
Sponsoring a child would teach my kids so much, but I don't have time for one more thing. Grace, you still need a sponsor. No more excuses. I'm doing this now. God works in mysterious ways. He pursues us. He interrupts our lives wherever we are. Our excuses are no match for His plans for us. If He's whispering to your heart, will you listen?
I used to think I was ugly, but my sponsor thinks I'm beautiful.
My sponsor was the first one to say, you can be anything that you want to be.
My sponsor told me Jesus loves me and He has a plan for me.
My sponsor's name is Hope and she loves me.
It was about 13 years ago when my wife and I guess about 14 years ago now, when my wife and I, we were still dating back in those days, but we were at a service, and all of a sudden in the middle of that service, they started talking about child sponsorship. And immediately as I heard that, I shut down, right? Because I had been to so many services and concerts where they started talking about, hey, this is something you could do. And I shut down and I said, God, I don't want to hear about this anymore. I've heard about it so many times. I don't have any desire. I don't have enough money. I said, I'm only one person. I can't change this entire world. There's so many kids in this world that need help. I'm only one person. So what difference, really, would it make if I sponsored a child? And then I sat. And as I sat, God whispered back. And I heard Him whisper softly to my heart, John, you know, you're probably right. You won't change this entire world. But today in this moment, God whispered, John, you could change this entire world for one little child. Make all the difference in the world for one little child and see that I'll be faithful. And so my wife and I, we were still students back in those days, but we started sponsoring a child and we split it $15 and $15 back in the day is what it was. And after that year had passed, we were engaged to be married, and God whispered and said, John and Andrea, was I faithful to you? We said, yes, Father, you were. He said, well. So that year we started sponsoring a second little one. A third year, third child. A fourth year, fourth child. And 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 years later, our family now sponsors 12 little ones. Each month through Compassion. It's not because I'm some big recording artist from the U.S., because you know I'm from Edmonton, right? It's only because God has been faithful as we've been faithful to His whispers. And my heart and the heart of Compassion this morning, it is that no one would feel pressure, because if that's what happens, then what will take place is not going to be eternal. It's not going to be lasting. But my heart and the heart of Compassion Canada this morning is simply to say, this morning, could you ask Jesus? Jesus, are you whispering to me to sponsor a child or children? Maybe it's more than one. And if God whispers, then in faith this morning, would you do that on this Father's Day 2016? Maybe you will be a father to one of the fatherless ones in this world. Would you do something with me this morning? Because I could keep speaking, but that's not my heart. My heart is that you would hear God's whisper if this is something you're to do. And so in this brief moment of silence, would you ask God one question? God, if you are calling me to sponsor a child this morning, would you give me a number very clear on my heart and mind that I cannot escape it? Maybe God will say zero, but maybe He will say one or two or more. I don't know what He wants to whisper to you. So let's just bow our heads together. Father, in this moment of silence, just like little Samuel in the Bible, how he listened and he heard your whisper. Would you whisper to our hearts, maybe a number of kids this morning, and place it on our hearts and minds? Would you whisper, Father, for your servants are listening. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Maybe God whispered to you in that moment, or maybe he will as we close our morning this morning. But it's very simple. There is no contract to sign when you sponsor a child. It's only for as long as you're able to sponsor. And even a few months is a few months I see of carrying a candle of hope for one of these little ones and have a relationship. And when you're not able to anymore, that's all right, because that is what the body of Christ is all about. And someone else picks up that candle of hope and carries that a little bit further. But we have many little ones on their table out in the foyer there. Some of them, we have five little ones that have been waiting for more than a year to be sponsored. And the other ones have been waiting for a number of months. But it's very simple. You just go to the table, find the child that you want to sponsor, and take that form out. Just put your name and address on one side and how you want to do your first month's support on the other side. Just rip that off and give that to us, and then you take the child with you. It's that easy. And this morning, if you don't have a way of doing your first month's payment, that's all right. You just do your name and address on there and just return that to the table, and we'll help you further about how you can do that further. But just as a small way to say thank you, if you do sponsor a little one this morning, normally we give one CD away just to say thank you, but again, as I came in this morning, I sensed God say, no, John, I want you to do something more. So you'll get my CD called Roots of Worship, which has a number of the songs we sang this morning, that one there. But also maybe there's a little child in your life here, or one that you know that needs encouragement in their walk with Jesus. And so I wanted to give you a second CD as well. This is my kids' worship CD, one of my kids' worship CDs that on there. There's a prayer to ask Jesus into their hearts. And maybe there's a little one that you know that they could benefit right here next door. So I'd love to give you those two CDs just as a small way to say thanks this morning. But if God is whispering to you to live out your worship in a different way this morning, I encourage you to do that, that Jesus would be seen in you, Jesus would be found in you, because great is the faithfulness of God. Amen. As we close my time and before Pastor Shane comes up, yeah, I don't think he'll do actions to close the service, but would you just sing this chorus with me one more time? Great is your faithfulness, O God. Oh, great is your faithfulness, O my God. Your mercy is all that I see. Great is your faithfulness, O my God, and all that you've given to me morning by morning. Oh, morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, you've given to me. Morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, you've given to me. Oh, great is your faithfulness, oh my God. Your mercy is all that I see. Great is your faithfulness, oh my God, and all that you've given to me. Pastor Shane, would you come forward? And as he does, I just want to say thank you so much for allowing me to join with you in worship this morning. It has been a privilege and an honor, and I look forward to doing this again. Maybe it's not here in Calgary. Maybe it's in heaven someday. But until that day, may God richly bless you and your church family. Thank you so much.
Let's give John some appreciation. Fantastic. It was about 15 years ago, I joined a friend of mine at a conference, and I had the opportunity to hear from a guy named Bill, and this guy named Bill spoke into my life. Matter of fact, he called me out, and I got to hear Bill's story. Bill grew up in New York City. His mom was in the city, took him into the city, and she put him on a park bench and said, "Wait right here, Mom will be right back." She never went back. And for 3 days, he sat on that park bench, waiting for Mom to come. And she never came. And finally, on the third day, a man walked by and noticed that this child, who had been there day after day, was still there. He showed an interest in the child, fed the child, took the child home, loved the child, eventually adopted the child. And that child grew up to be Bill Wilson. I don't know if you know who Bill Wilson is or not, but Bill Wilson is pastor of Metro Ministries. 25,000 children a week go to his Sunday school in the roughest parts of New York. He is dad to thousands upon thousands of kids. And it started because a man took notice. That day, the Lord, after Bill called me out, I said that day my life will be about working with the hurting and the broken and the poor. Today, my family, being led by my daughter, is going to pick a child that we are going to sponsor. Pastor Dave took the children to YC, and she was texting me like crazy, saying she heard of this great ministry that was reaching out to children around the world, and children's lives are being changed. And I said, "Well, what was the name of it?" And she said, "Well, Compassion." And, "Dad, can I sponsor a child?" And I said, "Mackenzie, how about this? How about when you come home, we're going to have this really famous, awesome rock star guy that's going to come, and Compassion's going to be here, and we will pick a child out together as a family." And so we're going to do that today. My brothers and my sisters, out on the table, there's children that have been passed by for a year. We could end that today. My brothers and my sisters, we have the capability in this room actually to empty the tables. I don't think that's a big call. We could empty the tables today and make Compassion have to go find more children. Because you never know, like John said, we can change the world for a child. But maybe, just maybe, the child that your sponsor ends up changing a community, a village, a town, a nation, maybe even the world. Amen? So I want to encourage you, please stop by the table and let the Spirit of God lead you to a child that you can sponsor. And before we do that, Tom, I'm going to ask you to come up. John, come on up here. I normally don't do this kind of stuff, but I feel called to do it. I met John a little bit ago in the back, and I was impressed immediately with his genuineness and his humility. And I believe Scripture says that when we humble ourselves, God will what? Raise us up. And so I'm going to pray for favor for you, for your ministry, for your family, and for Compassion. Amen? All right. Father, right now I come before you this morning, and I thank you for your servant John. Father, this morning I have been impressed by His Spirit, His humility, His compassion, His genuineness, and His love for you. Father, in the name of Jesus, I ask that you would open doors that no one can shut. That you would give him favor. Father, more favor with you and more favor with the people that he comes in contact with. I pray that you would swing wide the doors of his ministry and that people's lives would be changed. And that people would be healed through his stories. Father, I thank you for his willingness to be here even today as his family is back home dealing with funerals and everything else, Father, that he still chose to come here. Father, I pray that right now that his family would have a profound sense of your presence and your spirit, that they would know you're there. And Father, I pray that John would get back quickly to celebrate Father's Day with his family. In your